How to find the gvulei hatfilin. One gvul hatfilin is the center of the arm. Going to some poiskim, that's the lowest place you can put in your tefillin, which is the lowest place that the apex of the heart, which is the tip of the heart, is found. The other poiskim say the tefillin should not be lower than the base of the bicep in full contraction. Bosor tefuach. How do you find these two gvulim? To find the center of the arm, you find the insertion of the deltoid muscle, which means the place where the shoulder muscle inserts itself to the humerus bone. You find this by raising your hand and tightening your arm and finding the center where there is no muscle there. You feel the bone itself is in between the muscles. You mark that place and the tefillin should be placed above that mark if you want to make sure that the tefillin should be level to the heart. Those who wear two sets of tefillin at the same time, they wear Rashi above this mark and the Rabbeinu Tam below the mark. You can also find this place by making horizontal line from the base of the pectoral muscle, the chest line, to the arm. The insertion of the deltoid and the base of the pectorals are the same. Any place above that line until the armpit, but on the part of the bone which is above the armpit, there is no cuboides there, there's no bicep muscle there, and it's not level to the heart. The tefillin should face the heart by pressing the whole time to the chest. When the hand is in hanging position, the side of the tefillin should be touching the chest. Like the mashmos of the Rambam, kesheyad bet marpeiko letzalos, when you press the armpit to the rib cage, the tefillin are directly facing the heart. To find the lowest place where it's considered cuboides, for those who are matir, the lower part of the cuboides. For that, the easiest way is to bend your arm and keep it sidewards, not up, but sidewards, and then twist your thumb upwards. You're going to see the contraction of the bicep very clearly, and you can see the difference between the bicep muscle and the break of the tendon. You mark that place, and that's the lowest place, which is considered bicep contraction. Lower than that would be a sophic bosor tafuach, and according to many poiskim, is posel gomur.
gentlemen, your next course is served. Ladies and gentlemen, your next course is served.
ויקח מאבני המקום, ויוסמר השויסוף, וישקע במקום ההוא. ויקח איזו אבן אשר סומר השויסוף, ויוסם אוסו מצבו, וייצוק שמן על ראשו. He starts with abonim, and he ends with אבן. The Gemara in Chulin, the Tzadik Aleph Beis, has this kasha. The Gemara answers, he made a marzev protection against the highest roos, and the abonim started to fight between each other. Olai, yoniach tzadik ez roisho, every stone wanted that the tzadik should put his head on that stone. So they came to Amachloikis, and the Rebbein Shloilom made up short. All the Avonim became one. So at the end of the Pasuk says that he took one Evan. They fused, became one Evan. The Mogen Avrom and Simen Mem Beis, if cotton gimel, by the two Satfilin Shul Yad. Next to the Beis we make a Kesher Yud. And the other edge, we tie the Tfilin on the hand. Kafayat. If somebody wants to switch the size of the Tfilin and he wants to put the Kesher on the other side, and the Kesher that was next to the Beis, he wants to put it next to the Kafayat. Mogen Avrom does not like that, because Ein Moridin Bakoidesh, the Kedusha's Yud, was next to the Beis, now it's not next to the Beis. The Yud has more Kedusha. But the Lior Rabo argues with the Mogen Avrom, and he brings down from his Zede, from his grandfather, that there is such a thing as Moridin Bakedusha in one thing. This is wonder too. By switching the sides, he's not being Moridin Bakedusha. And he brings a Rai from this Gemara. Once the Avonim were fused, they did not fight anymore. Even though Yankov even did not put his head on the entire Evan. Same thing with the Ritzur. It's wonder too. There's no Hoyrod Bekedusha by switching the sides. The Machaber says, at the end of the Ritzur, you should be Koisher. At the beginning of Simon Chof Zayin, that Kshira is a Chelik from the Ritzur. You should not leave the Ritzur just hanging without a Kshira. At least you should be Toikev, you should. In the Kafayad, you should wind it at least twice. Two Tkifas is like a Kshira, like a Tfiro. Kolo Oimer Lipol Kenofu Domi. Agav, how does it work that he puts his head on those stones and he'll be protected from the highest rose? Apiteva doesn't work, but we can say perhaps that was the Mizbeach that Noach was makriv all the korbonos, like the Rambam says. Same Mizbeach of Odom Rishon, Noach,
and the Mizbeach of the Akedah. Because Rabbi Elazar also brings down the Avonim from the Mizbeach from Avraham Avinu. And that's the Mizbeach that Shlomo HaMelech rebuilt. In that Mizbeach, every single behemo was nikrav. So by putting his head on that even, he was protected from any chayro. In this parsha, we have the mitzvah of Anochas Tfilin, to put on Tfilin. And the parsha says, V'samtem ez devorai eile al levavchem, the Tfilin should be level to the heart. Rashi in Menochas, as well as in Mesecht Megillah, Tafchov Dalet, Menochas Lamed Zayin, that the Tfilin should be begova shebeyat, in the high part of the Zroya, somoch lekosef, close to the shoulder. This way is level to the heart. The Goyim say, you should not have the Tfilin in any part of the upper arm, but up to the center of the upper arm. Plug Zroa, half of the upper arm, half of the humerus bone. Which half? The half which is level to the heart. In Shulchan Aruch says, you should put the tefillin from the center of the arm until the elbow, because you need the tefillin should be level to the heart. From the center of the arm until the elbow, that's where it's going to be considered level to the heart. Neged halev, sometimes the word ayel alevavchem. The problem is that the heart is from the center of the arm till the armpit, not till the elbow. And the Shulchan Aruch is following Rabbeinu Peretz, who explains that the Goyim say that the tefillin should be placed from the plug zroya until the hatzil, and the hatzil he calls the elbow, like Tosfos says. But this is not so simple, because Rashi and Tosfos and most places in Shas argue what is the translation of hatzil, which in Targum is marpek. Rashi says hatzil means the armpit, axilio. Rabbeinu Tam says elbow. So when the Goyim says from Chotzi until the Atzil, and should be Neged Alef, is Lav Davke that the Geoini meant elbow, like Rabbeinu Tam, but maybe the Geoini meant from the center of the arm until the armpit, the upper half of the arm. Therefore, the Vilna Gaon argues with the Shulchan Aruch and the Ramo, and it says that you may put the tefillin on the upper half of the arm. But according to what we just said, you should not be able to put the tefillin in the lower half of the arm, especially since we need the tefillin should be level to the heart. The heart sees only one half of the arm, one half of the humerus bone. Which half, the upper half or the lower half? The heart is between the second rib, close to the neck, to the sixth rib, up to the beginning of the chest line, the pectoral muscle. When the hand is in hanging position, it's true that only one half of the arm is going to be level to the heart, and that is the upper half of the arm, level to the heart, not the lower half of the arm, making the psak of the Vilna Gaon much stronger. So if somebody wants to have the tefillin, should fit between the beginning of the biceps until the center of the arm, and is going to use only the lower half of the arm, he's going to have a very small space, and no part of the tefillin should stick out, should come out from the gvul ha-tefillin. So some people came with a new suggestion, that you should not measure the biceps in full contraction, but rather when the hand is relaxed, hanging down, and the space becomes very wide until the elbow. Like it's mashmas in the Shulchan Aruch. Some say, no, we need bosor tofuach, contracted bicep. But it's going to be a very small space. So they decided to make semi-contracted. It is a kulo, especially today's tefillin are much bigger than the tefillin that used to have in Europe. Ben be'ashkenaz, ben be'svart, the tefillin were very small, like Beis Yosef said, the meaning was to have the tefillin pochos mike'etzba by the titur. Then you can put the tefillin in a small space. But actually we have the problem that the tefillin has to be level to the heart, le'ikuva. For that, the best etzah is to put the tefillin in both parts, first at the lower half of the arm and then at the upper half of the arm. Those who put two sets of tefillin at the same time, they put rashis in the upper half and Rabbeinu Tam in the lower half. Even then you should be machmir and put each one of them separately in both sides to be yoytze midei sofik. The truth is there's no sofik whatsoever. The heart is not at all lower.
Vayar Yosef ki yoshis oviv yad yeminoi al rosh Efraim vayero be'enov vayismoich yad oviv lehosir oiso me al rosh Efraim al rosh Menashe. The Torah makes a big asek with the hands of Efraim and Menashe and Yosef and Yankev. What is all this about? Believe it or not, many alochos of Hilchos Tefillin are learned from this parsha, from this psukim between Yaakov and Yosef. Why the Torah says over here, Yad Yeminoi and Yad Stam? The Gemara says, Menochos, Lamed Zayin Lamed Alef, Ukshatim Lo Sal Yodecho, what means Yodecho, Zoi, small, left hand. Tefillin you put on the left hand. Ato Oimer, small, Oi Eno Elo Yemin, maybe means the right hand. Tamut Loimer says in Yishayo, Yodi, Yozdo, Oretz, Vimini, Tipecho, Shomayim, my hand
created the earth, and my right hand created Shomayim. Stam yad means small. Standard hand means the left hand. We find yod, which means standard hand, and it also means the right hand. Where? By Yosef. Yosef grabbed the hand of his father, which was on the head of Ephraim. Which hand was that? The right hand. So when we say the word yod, it also means the right hand. So how do you know that when the Torah says ukshartem lo oisal yodecho, it means the left hand? The Gemara answers yad yemino ikri yad stamol lo ikri. You don't find the word yad to mean the right hand unless it says yad yeminoi. Toises as a kasher in posik says yad yeminoi and says also stam yad uviv. So you see that the posik calls stam yad even though it's a right hand. So what is pshat in Rabbi Yosei achoyrim? So Toises says adrabo. Since the Torah had to write over here yad yeminoi, and in the same post it says yad oviv, is to tell you that unless it says yeminoi, it means yad small. And from here, actually, Tosfos says, is that we learned aloha that standard yad means yad small. Unless the Torah says meferesh, yeminoi or yad yeminoi. And from this post we learned the hilchos tefillin. Yankev avinu pus his left hand on the head of Menashe. And he tells them, Menashe, we're going to learn now hilchos tefillin. Tone de bei Menashe al yotcho zoiki boires. When the Torah says you put a tefillin on the hand, doesn't mean any place in the hand. It means on the kiboires. How do you know that? There's three way machloikis. Tanekamo, Rabbi Eliezer ben Hurkanus, and Rabbi Yitzchok. The Tanekamo is going to learn from a hekesh of tefillin shel yad to tefillin shel roish. When the Torah says bein einecho, does not mean between your eyes, but means begoiva sheberoish, all the way on top. So make a hekesh of tefillin shel roish to tefillin shel yad. When the Torah tells you al yotcho, it doesn't mean on your hand and your wrist. It means begoiva shebeyad, in the high part of your arm. And the hekesh is merumos sikeles yodov. The left hand is resting on the right hand, and the right hand is on top of the head of Ephraim, al roish Ephraim. We have a hekesh shel yad to the shel roish. A believer says, I don't have to come to this hekesh. I can learn from the posuk says, which part of the arm is always covered? The upper part of the arm. Rabbi Yitzchok Oimer, I can learn from the posuk, Vesamtem es devorai eila levavchem ukeshartem. Which part of the arm is level to the heart? The upper part of the arm. Rabbi Chiyo have mechaven umunach legabe libe. Rabbi Chiyo was mechaven, and the twin should be very well positioned, level to the heart. The Shemush Rabbo brings down that only plag zroya is kosher for tefillin. Only half of the zroya is kosher for tefillin. What does that mean, only half? The half which is mechuvan keneged the heart. So this that says b'shem, devei menashe, that the kiboides is the mokom anuchos tefillin shel yad, the biceps, it does not mean the entire biceps. It means the part of the biceps which is level to the heart. And for that, you have to divide the arm in half. Upper arm, which is called the humerus bone, the etzema zroya, only half of that arm sees and is level to the heart. And actually, the upper half of the arm sees the heart, not the lower half of the arm. And that's the way Rabbi Nochanan learns, and that's the mashmos of the Rambam. The marpek is the armpit, the Rambam says in the Pirush HaMishnayos. And that's the hekesh of tefillin shel rosh also. Just like the tefillin shel yad, you can only be half of the arm, because only half of the arm sees the heart. The tefillin shel rosh also, not the entire shipur is kosher tefillin, but up to the kotkoit, up to the part of the head which is soft, and that is only chotzi shipur, half of the shipur, from the hairline up to the kotkoit. The tefillin shel yad teaches the tefillin shel rosh where to put on. The shel yad is only plag zroya, half of the zroya. The shel rosh also half of the shipur. So sikeles yodov, by putting the hands in a cross way, is making a hekesh shel yad to the shel rosh. Tane b'menashe al yod chuzuki boires, and means only the chelik which is mechuvan keneged leiv, like Rabbi Yitzchok learns. The shel rosh also, at Rosh Ephraim, it means only up to half of the shipur of the kotkoit. Half of Shevet Menashe is going to be in Eretz Yisrael, because Reuven, God, and Chotzi Menashe took the other side of the Yarden. And the Chelik of Menashe is right next to the Yam Kineres. And Yam Kineres is Doime Lelev. Besamtem is Devorai Eila Levavchem. Just like the Tefillin. Only the part of the arm which is level to the heart is kosher for tefillin. Tone de bei menashe, al yot chuzuki boides, which part? Simo keneget alev. have the Shevet Menashe, which is next to the Yam Kineres, which is Doimel Lelev. Even though in Shulchan Aruch it's mashma that the Markbek is the elbow, like Rabbeinu Tam says, nevertheless, Rabbeinu Hananu learns, like Rashi, that the Markbek means the armpit. Atzil is the Aktzilia. Atzil is the Markbek, the Targum of Markbek. The Mechab and the Ramo pass the upper half of the arm, because only Plag Zroya is kosher, which Plag Zroya, the plaque which is towards the Markbek. And they learn Markbek means the elbow, like Rabbeinu Tam. But the Vilna Gaon does not agree with Mechab and the Ramo and says the upper half of Tefillin is also kosher. And the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch also is matter the upper half. But since it's a Sofik D'Raisa L'Choiro, it should be Machmir to put on Tefillin only on one half. Which half? We don't know. Only in the lower half and only in the upper half. You could be Yoitze by moving the Tefillin, just like by a Sofik lefty. Somebody's a Sofik, if it's a righty or lefty, he puts on Tefillin in each hand separately. Here also we have a Sofik, which half of the Zroyo is kosher for Tefillin, the upper half or the lower half, of course, in the Mokom HaKiboyres. So the only way to be Yoitze L'Choladeus is to move the Tefillin. No part of the Tefillin should be lower than the Kiboyres and no higher than the upper half. And afterwards, no part of the Tefillin should be lower than the mediumer's bone. And that's the real, true Neged HaLev. The heart comes down up to the sixth rib. Heart is situated between the second intercostal space till the sixth intercostal space. In other words, between the second rib and the fifth rib. Vayakeo elachoimesh. And he killed them by hitting him on the fifth rib, Rashi says. Because the heart is higher than the fifth rib. The fifth rib is at mid-humerus bone. So by putting tefillin only on the lower half, you're going to be missing the heart. 846 years. Abraham lived 175. Yitzchok, 180. Yaakov, 147. Suro, 127. Rivka, 133. Rochel, 37. Leah, 47. 846. Begematrio, Shem, Havayo, Nikro, Olecho. In Posik says, Verokol Ameho Oretz, Kishem Havayo, Nikro, Olecho, Viyorom Emeko, Omer Abeliezer, Elu Tfilin Sheberoish. How is Merumas in Tefillin Sheberoish? There's a shin on the right side with three heads, and there's a shin with four heads on the left side. And Sefer Boruch Sheomar says it's Merumas on the Ovos, Avrohom, Yitzchok, Yankov, Soro, Rivka, Rochel, Veleo. In the names of the Ovos, Avrohom, Yitzchok, Yankov, Soro, Rivka, Rochel, Veleo, there are 26 Oisius. Keminyan Shem Havayo. Shem Havayo, Nikro, Olecho, is also Begematrio, the years of the Ovos and the Imoos.